North of the city, on the way to Bear Mountain, is a lovely-looking place called the Letchworth Village Rehabilitation Center. Set among the hills and woods of suburban Rockland County, a passerby could easily mistake the place for a country club or a college campus. But the early morning mist gave the place an eerie feeling, like a set from a horror movie. Once inside, that feeling became suddenly appropriate.
Why are these patients unclothed?
We don't have enough clothing. We don't have the proper help to keep clothing on them. We have a few nudists that will not keep clothes on. They will pull them off. But most of all, we don't have the help to keep the kids properly dressed.
Very well-built building. Inside we have housed the children of many of our citizens who are subjected to what appears to be the worst possible conditions I've ever seen in my life. I've visited penal institutions all over the country. I've visited hospitals all over the country. I've visited the worst rigs in the military. I've never seen anything like it.
About 25% of the funding for Letchworth Village comes from the federal government, and one of the requirements for continued eligibility is that there be 80 square feet of space per patient. Here they get only 35 square feet. In the face of this terrible overcrowding, there was a ward there that stood empty because they hadn't the funds to hire the 38 people it would take to staff it. There's at least one more horrifying aspect of life at Letchworth. More than 300 able-bodied patients, both physically and mentally able to work outside the institution, are not being allowed to. They're being used to fill the places of the too few employees. They get paid $2 a week for their efforts, about what they'd make each hour on the outside. What we need is a new approach. We have to change the way we care for our mentally retarded. We ask for change, we demand change. What you've seen here just doesn't have to be this way.